Students, today I am taking the topic from class 10 civics, and that is popular struggles and movements. In our civics book, whenever we start our chapter, the first thing which NCERT gives us is a story. Here also there is a story of two nations. The first story is about the country Nepal. Now if we see Nepal, then there was a monarchy in Nepal. Means there is a king's rule in Nepal. But in the year 1990-91, King Birendra Vikram decides to start democracy in his country. So there was a elections in that country, but unfortunately, because of the mysterious massacre of the royal family, that is in the year 2001, the whole royal family of Nepal was killed. Then after that, the elder son of King Birendra Vikram, that is King Gyanendra, become the king of Nepal. Now it is the rule of King Gyanendra. What King Gyanendra is done, that whenever there was a democratic rule in the country or the government, he dismissed or dissolved that government. One by one, King Gyanendra done these activities many times. After all, जैसा कि हम कहते भी हैं कि पाप का घड़ा भर जाता है तो फूट जाता है. Similarly happened the same thing here also. Now the peoples are totally against of King Gyanendra, and what they done is that they all come on road, and that was started by SPA. What is SPA? SPA is a seven party alliance. Means all the political parties, including the ruling parties and the opposition parties, comes together and become an alliance. Called SPA, that is the seven party alliance. On other hand, the second major group of Nepal was Maoist. Now Maoist also come and join this movement against King Gyanendra. People defied curfews and took to the streets. More than 1 lakh people who gathered almost every day to demand restorations of democracy in the country. And we can see the same thing on 1st April 2006 that more than 5 lakh protesters reached between 3 to 5 lakhs on road. Now this movement was also joined by students, lawyers, teachers and etc. So this is how we see that a problem raised in a country, Nepal, the people one by one, different organizations and people joined this movement, this mobilization become very huge, and one day comes when King Gyanendra in the year 2006 resigned from his post and democracy was established in Nepal. So here in this story we see that there was a democracy. First of all, there was a democracy, but before that there was a rule of king. Now the king, rule of the king, and start democracy in Nepal in 1990 sorry, and it was actually constitutional monarchy in Nepal. Then a time period comes when a dictatorship style of rule of King Gyanendra was there in Nepal, which was ended peacefully through a movement in the year 2006, and democracy was established in Nepal. So the democracy established in Nepal peacefully through a great movement. Now let us come to the second story of the chapter. The story of the chapter is from the country Bolivia. If we come to the country Bolivia, Bolivia is a very small country of South America. In this country there was a democracy. Now the problem in this country is not from the government. The problem in this country is from the policy of the government. We can easily understand this story by the example recently happened in India, that is the Anna Hazare example. In India also there is a democracy, but we are not agree with the policy of the government of India related to the Bill of Lokpal. Similarly, the people of Bolivia are not happy with the policy of the Bolivian government, and that policy related to the water supply of that country. There is a city of Cochabamba, where in that city government, the municipal corporation of that city decided to give the service of water supply to MNC. This MNC is of the country America. Now before this, people received a bill of 1000 rupees in a month, but when MNC took over the service of water supply in Cochabamba country, where the average bill was increased by 1000 rupees. Before that it was very low, but now the people receive 1000 rupees bill, which is actually very high in the country where the monthly average income of the people is only 5000. So the people of Bolivia are not happy with the policy of the government. Now here they all come together, and there is an organization, an NGO. The name of that NGO is FETCOR. Now this NGO lead this movement, the problems of the people, in a very formal manner. And one day comes when, because of the this so much too much protest of the people, even then the government imposed a martial law in the country. The whole people of the city, they all come on roads and start protesting against the MNCs. Now MNCs was cancelled and run from the country, and this is how the water supply was restored to municipality at old rates. So now in the both country, the first one is Nepal and the second one is Bolivia. In Nepal the people were against of the government, against of the ruler, and they established democratic government in that country. While in Bolivia there was already a democratic country in Bolivia, the people were actually against of one of the policy of the government. But because of the too much pressure of the people in both the country, we can see that democracy was established in Nepal in the year 2006, and on other hand the government ऑफ कोचाबाम्बा इन बोलिविया कैंसल्ड द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ वाटर सप्लाई विद एमएनसीज. सो दिस इज द स्टोरी गिवन इन आवर बुक. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर. नाउ बेटा इन आवर चैप्टर द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑफ द हेडिंग इज मोबिलाइजेशन एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मोबिलाइजेशन एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. बिफोर दैट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज मोबिलाइजेशन. मोबिलाइजेशन द एग्जांपल वी कैन टेक फ्रॉम नेपाल मींस देयर इज एसपीए joined by Maoist, joined by lawyer, later joined students, common men, teachers, the other societies, and this is how this small movement mobilized slowly slowly and become a big movement. And different people, community join the movement means a small movement mobilized. कोई भी चीज जो छोटी सी है उसमें और लोग जुड़ते जाएं तो उसे हम कहते हैं mobilization. मतलब उसका बढ़ना फैलते जाना that is called the mobilization. On other hand, organization is totally a formal activity where there is an organization which is doing its work in a very formal manner. As we see in Bolivian story where there is a organization, an NGO organization, FATCO. This is about mobilizations and organization. Now, I think the topic mobilization and organization is clear. Let us come to our next topic, and our next topic is pressure group and movement. This topic we will continue in our second part of this topic. The topic is popular struggle and movements. Thank you.